everybody, Super Baby Mario here, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario 64. In the last part, we finished up the game by taking on Bowser in the sky, and in this part, we're gonna be starting up the DS version. First time I've had a DS game on my channel, because, you know, this one's on the Wii U. I don't have a DS capture card, unfortunately, but, you know, those are expensive and stuff, so I don't think that's going to be happening anytime soon. So, yeah, this is the same as usual, except Peach is a lot less terrible looking. And so is Lakitu, except he wasn't that bad looking in the original either. But whatever. His cloud is so happy, though. And Yoshi's taking a nap on the roof, like he does. Like he do. But yeah, this version has a lot of different modes, like, that were added to the game when putting it on the DS. Oh, hey, look, it's Mario. Nobody would have guessed Mario was in this game. Definitely not by looking at the title. But yeah, to start out with, I'm going to be just covering all of the changes that were made to, like, the actual main story game thing pants, and then Luigi just kind of jumps on Wario's head because he's apparently a closet asshole. And yeah, that's the first major difference, is that Mario is not alone in this game. There are, in fact, Luigi and Wario, as well as Mario. Oh, and I guess there's Yoshi, too. Apparently he teleported from the top of the castle down to the ground while still being asleep. Because, you know, Yoshi's an Abra, apparently. So yeah, plot twist, we don't actually start the game as Mario. We start as Yoshi. Because Yoshi's cool like that. So, another major difference is that, because the DS doesn't really have an analog stick, there is, now a run button. And also, you can't get into the castle yet, you need to find a key. And, yes, can I help you, Lakitu?
Uh-oh, looks like the door's locked, huh? It's just a
rabbit, taking the key, touch screen map. Yeah, as you can see on the map there, the key is flashifying, because it's cool like that. Also, I haven't played the DS version in a long-ass time, so expect me to forget the controls every 2 seconds. Especially since they're very different from the N64 version. And now it's a bunny, and I ate it, and it's, yeah, that's another major addition to this game, is that there's a whole bunch of rabbits around the castle, eventually. I think it's, like, after you get the first star they start spawning, but, yeah, there's a bunch of rabbits, and they will unlock certain things if you catch them. And, they're not just for Yoshi, either. There's ones for, the other three as well. But you have to unlock the other three first, too. Yeah, that's the same as always. So, we're gonna do the same thing as we usually do, and we're gonna go into Bob-omb Battlefield. So we're starting with star number one, Big Bob-omb on the summit. Which, is slightly different from the original game, which is why I'm showing it. But yeah, as for Yoshi's controls, he's, a lot different from the other three. He's got, obviously, the flutter jump, if you hold down the A button. He can eat things, or sorry, the B button is jump, not A. But yeah, you can you can eat things by pressing A. And then if you press R while you have something in your mouth, then if it is compatible, then you can turn it into an egg. which I will show with yonder Goomba. Yay. It's an egg. You'll give me an egg! Yeah, and of course, we've still got da warps. And yeah, it shows on the map which location you have warped to. So now we've got King Bob-omb.
I'm the Big Bob-omb, Baron of all blasting matter, King of Kaboom's the world over. Incredible, you made it this far even without a mustache. I commend your courage. Be that as it may, I can't just give you my precious power star. You must defeat me in battle if you want it. You'll be quite helpless facing my Bob-omb minions. Now put your tongue back in your mouth. It's quite undignified. Let's battle!
So, yeah, first boss here. Gonna not get an extra hit on him immediately with the egg. Apparently he doesn't take damage from egg. This is not a thing that I was aware of. But yeah, that's the only real difference in this one, is that the method of fighting him is different, because Yoshi can't grab people. So you instead just eat his Bob-ombs and spit them at him, and the other one exploded somehow instantaneously, and I got hurt, except I didn't actually take damage somehow. Oh, that hurts. How did I lose to a bald-faced fellow like you? Let's just keep this if it's a power star, if it's a star. So yeah, there's first star here. Om nom. Yeah, Yoshi can eat stars with his face. Which, that's actually a semi-popular challenge run of this game, is that is to get as many stars as you can by eating them with Yoshi. So, gonna go into here again. Foot race with Koopa the Quick. It's, you know, still the same as usual, except... Oh my god, Yoshi. Come on.
Howdy, do you know where Mario is? I've been looking, but he's nowhere to be found if you know there's Mario.
So yeah, you can't race Koopa the Quick as Yoshi. So rather than you know, leaving and coming back, we have an alternate method of Marioing, which is to find one of the assorted Mario hats scattered across the stage. Except there are only two in most worlds. Actually, usually there's only one, but whatever. While searching for the power stars, you found a red cap. Put it on, and voila, you suddenly look at Mario, this is Mario, the A. You know, from the famous wall kick, just press A. Wow, the game lies. You press B to jump. But yeah, Mario is the only person in the game who can do the wall jump. Luigi and Wario can't for some reason, even though they can in other games. Or at least Luigi can. I don't think Wario is able to in any game. I might be wrong. But anyways, we're gonna just race Mr. Koopa here. And I don't really need to show it, so I won't. Fast. So yeah, there's a second star. I'm not gonna be showing stars that are unchanged from previous versions. I just wanted to show off the cap mechanic. Also, you can press the L button to center the camera behind you, which I forgot about briefly. And also, if you, I just learned this, if you pick up a Mario cap while you already have a Mario cap on, then you just get a 1-up, which is cool. So yeah, now we can enter back into Bob-omb Battlefield and get 5 silver stars, the first completely new mission in this world. And, a new type of mission that was introduced in this game. Basically, you have to go around the world and collect 5 silver stars, which, you know, would be semi-difficult if they weren't on the map. But yeah, they're just, you know, hanging out. And the Chain Chomp has moved slightly from his original post. So, Yoshi, eat the damn star. There we go. Good boy.
Who's a good dinosaur?
You are! Sometimes. But yeah, they completely took out Shoot to the Island in the Sky in this version. So that's a thing. They added this star, as well as star number 4 is now Big Bob-omb's Revenge, which is the exact same as the original, or the first star from the original game, so I don't really need to show that one. And plus, I don't think we can even do it yet, because it requires Mario, and I'm not sure if Mario caps spawn in that particular mission. Herp-a-derp. And I just realized that I need the cannon, I think. Wait, no, what am I talking about? The star's down here. It's inside this good old-fashioned Goomba, and we'll just spit him at his buddy there. Yeah, I think I was thinking of one of the red coins that was on the island. Which, yeah, cannons are still opened in the same way. Just talk to a Bob-omb buddy. And what the hell is the camera doing? I thought it was supposed to be better in this version. But unfortunately, I have not played this version in, like, 2 or 3 years. Since, like, whenever it was that I played it in that one episode of Jordan Plays Tomb Raider. Which I think was episode 14 or 13 or something? Whatever, Om Nom. Yeah, you can even eat the star through that little glass thing that spawns. Alright, so we now have 3 stars, which enables us to, once again, enter Jolly Roger Bay and or Cool Cool Mountain. Not at the same time, because that would be strange. Not gonna do anything else in the battlefield of Bob-ombs, because all the rest of the stars are exactly the same. So, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into this one-star door, which previously housed frickin' Princess's Secret Slide, which is still there. It's right over here. Hi. You are a secret slide. And, if we go up to this door with an L here, it's locked. Someone's shrieking on the other side. The M one, it's locked. Someone is calling for help on the other side. The W, it's locked. Someone is growling on the other side. And this blank white one, it's locked. Everything is quiet on the other side. So yeah, obviously these three are where the 3 other playable characters are being held, and the other one is just a thing. A thing that I will be getting to much later. Except it might not actually be much later. It might be soon. Who knows? So this toad here is a little bit of a dum-dum. No, find the keys for me, Yoshi, blah 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 blah. So yeah, he's lost the keys to this. So there are, I believe, 24 keys scattered around Princess Peach's castle. And, yeah, you can find them, and they unlock mini-games. Which, there are, I believe there are 6 keys for each character, but I could be wrong. It's either 6 or 8. But, yeah, I just kind of entered this painting with no real explanation as to what this is. This is, one of the new mini areas that was added to the DS version. This is Sunshine Isles. And, yeah, it's basically just a 5 silver star challenge. Whoa, what? No. Yeah, if you get hit, you lose a silver star, which, I mean, it's easy enough to get back, especially if you're Yoshi, but... And we're just gonna be a dick to Lakitu here and just throw stuff at... Where's the star? Is it on the top of the tree? I thought it was inside the Goomba. But I guess it's in the tree? It's in the tree. Okay. And Yoshi impales himself on the tree because... can, I guess. And there's also one here in this little alcove. Where's our good buddy? Hello, Klepto. It's nice to see ya. Good to see you've expanded your territory and are not just in Shifting Sandland now. Whoa, no. Okay, Goomba, really? Wow, that Silver Star just wanted to be in my possession, like, so badly that it bounced just straight into me. I'm okay with this. Anyways, that's all five. And I don't know why, but I thought I was going to take fall damage there, which would have been slightly irritating, but not day-ruining. But now we have another secret star. Actually, a secret star. That was the only one that... That's the only one that we have so far. And, we are gonna do some things with some stuff and some pants. So over here in Womp's Fortress, this is where our good buddy the Mario Cap is. And, that is a good thing, because it is required for the star that we are about to attempt to obtain. What? Alright, did not know there was a warp there. That's... Ow, no! No, I need that for stuff! Wait, it's... Oh, it respawned in a different spot? That's not allowed. Aha! So you are the one who has stolen my hat. Well, joke's on you, Mr. Goomba. Oh! Okay, I guess the joke's on me. Alright, so let's try that again, this time without the death. So, there's a little bit of a new section added to Womp's Fortress, and there's this block here, which brings up the other major new star, or mission type, that was added to this game, which is the Switch Star. Basically, you step on that switch, obviously, and a star appears in... in this glass thing here, and you have to get to it within a certain amount of time or it will disappear. Which I did, so that was cool. Also, that was star number 7 of Womp's Fortress. The other 6 are exactly the same, so I'm not going to be showing any of them, because I'm cool like that! Let's see if we can get... Actually, I don't think any of the stars in... any of the new stars in Cool Cool Mountain or Jolly Roger Bay are accessible right now. So I'm just gonna do some things with some stuff and some penguins. Alright, Bob-omb Battlefield is now completely cleared out. And now that we have 8 stars, or in this case 9, we can go over to this away and go inside this door with an 8 on it! Reacting to the star power, the door slowly opens. That's what it does. Hey, look, it's a Mario. And nothing else of interest. We can't jump out the window, unfortunately. So let's go jump into Mario's face. So this is a new area once again. This is called Goomboss Battle. Which, yeah, I wonder what we're going to be doing here. Hello there, Mr. Bob-omb Buddy. How you doing? But, yeah, some of the Bob-omb Buddies in this game will show you where red coins are. I do not remember where any of them are in this, this particular mini-world, so that is a bit of a lifesaver there. Not that I'm gonna remember where they are anyway, but it's good to have. This over here leads to a Switch Star that we can't get, because, it requires certain plumbers who can wall kick. Oh, wait, can we not even get the red coins here? Is there one inside that block there? I'm thinking there might be one inside that block there, which, kind of screws up my plans here a little bit, but... You know, I'll survive. Instead, I'll just throw eggs at people. Yeah, that's a lot of coins. Something cool about the eggs is that for every time they hit an enemy, not only does said enemy drop coins because, you know, they're dead, but the egg itself drops the same amount of coins. Like, it drops coins equal to the amount of coins that the enemy would have given. So, like, if you eat, if you turn a Lakitu into an egg, like I just did, then every time it hits an enemy, it'll give you 5 coins, which it can make for some crazy combos. But anyways, inside here, we've got the Goomba King from Paper Mario. I'm no ordinary Goomba, I am Goomboss. Totally not the Goomba King. The Great Goomba, the Grand Poobah Goomba, whatever that means. Stomp, 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 another table turn, I've knocked him up in a room, stomps. So yeah, this is a brand new boss fight for this game. We've got Goomboss, and he's very easy. We just have to throw eggs at him. And he conveniently provides... ow. He conveniently provides... ow, yes. He provides Goombas with which to make said eggs by shitting them out. Why did that not work? Okay, let's try that again. Ha-doink-a-doink-a-doink. There we go. Unfortunately, the Goombas here don't give you coins. Which, that would be pretty useful, honestly. I guess they don't want you trying to go for, like, 100 coin star in Goomboss battle. That would be... come on! Hit the damn thing. Ow. Ow. Heh. Die. No, not me. Almost got knocked off the cliff by a Goomba. That would have been shameful. Ow! This is already shameful. It's getting into shameful territory. Jesus! Oh, I died. I died to Goombas. I don't even have words. Let's do that again. What the shit? That was different. Okay. Oh, that hit him? All right then. Mario, beat me. Jeez, that was ridiculous. That is literally the first time I've ever had any problems with that boss. Let's player's curse, I tell ya. But yeah, now we have this awesome key with an M on it. And we have cleared Goomboss battle. Do-do-do-do-do-do. So, now we can go back this way, go into the door, and, not that one. Hi. Now we've unlocked the star of the show. You've rescued Mario. Now he can smash Bowser in style. Red caps are everywhere. Grab one to turn into Mario. Thwart Bowser's sinister plans with super moves. Yay. So, now that we've got Mario, let's go back inside, because, you know, he totally doesn't have PTSD towards this place from being captured and taken prisoner in... Wait, no, he wasn't taken prisoner here. It was inside that... I don't even know what I'm talking about, apparently. Whatever. Let's... ow. Excuse me. Really, Mario? Really? You're just gonna dive straight into that piranha plant? I'm so disappointed! Okay, this is not gonna go well. This is already not going well. Let's kill a Goomba or get killed by a Goomba. That is twice. Twice in the first episode. Well, I guess it's not... It's technically the 17th episode, but, you know. No. No virtual console menu. Oh my god, really? There we go. Good job, Mario. You can make it past simple jumps. Star switch. Star. Over there. Got a wall jump. They made wall jumping a lot easier in this version, which I screwed up anyway. Mario. Mario, come on, man! Alright, punch the fucking Goomba. Send him to his doom, and step on the switch again. So, take two. Yay! See, Mario, was that so hard? That would be a maybe. And we still can't get the other star, because I'm pretty sure that one of the red coins is inside that black block that we can't break. So, gonna wait around to get another star, I guess. Another new star, that is. Ooh, I've got just the one. So, let's head over towards Big Boo's haunt. So, in this here courtyard, there's... I think there might be the same amount of boos as there were before, but, now some of them have red coins. In fact, almost all of them have red coins. Ow, my god, why am I terrible? Yay, red coins in the courtyard. For some dumb reason, a lot of people seem to think that this star is glitched. And, like, if you collect all the other stars before this one, then you won't be able to get this one, which is just completely wrong. Like, that's not a thing that happens at all in this, in this game. And is the Big Boo not here? Because you're supposed to be able to get into Big Boo's haunt. Do you need a certain number of stars? Because I don't think I've ever actually come to the courtyard this early. But, sure, I'll save. And, let's go for one more. Inside this grate here, we've got the secret of Battle Fort! Which, not to be confused with Battle Fart, which is not a thing. But, yeah, 5 silver stars here. There's one. I thought I was standing on nothing for a second there. Oh, hi, Chuck, yeah? You are a lot more animated in this version. I did not remember that at all. Heave-ho, you can just piss right off. There should be one inside this Goomba. Ha-ha. Yeah. Don't want to get hit by the bowling balls of sadness. No, don't want to get hit by a Goomba either. Whoa! Get our freaking star back. One of them should be inside one of these here blocks, like this one right here. And as we can see on our map, the other one is on the other side of the place. And that's where the star is gonna spawn. Yay. Yay, points for style. I was gonna slide kick into him, but I forgot how to. And plus, slide kicking is really awkward to do while you're running, because, you know, the run button is Y, and you press A to kick things, and that just doesn't work well at all. But we've gotten a decent amount of stars. I think we've shown 6 or 7 new ones? I don't even know, but anyways, we now have 12 stars. So I think that's a good place to end things off. So next time on Let's Play Super Mario 64 DS, we're going to show, some more stuff, but we're going to start with what's new in Bowser in the Dark World. Because there's new stuff in Bowser in the Dark World, from what I can recall at least. So thank you all for watching, and I will see you then. By the way, you can't get in this door if you're playing as Yoshi. It's just not a thing. Yeah, bye.